What's up, Hounds, and welcome back to Hounds TV.
This is Sam, and I'm Ben, and we're super excited to bring you our 12th episode.
This Wednesday, the female rugby team left for the Maritimes as a part of their rugby exchange program.
In case you forgot, our school hosted the Newfoundland Provincial Rugby Team back in April.
And now, for the second part of the exchange, our girls will head to Newfoundland to learn a little bit about the world of the East.
Have fun, girls. Next up, we'll have Dane with Hounds on the Street, and then Mason with a report from his National Fencing Championship that took place from May 17th to 20th in Saskatoon.
Welcome back to another episode of Hounds TV. Let's go. Today I'm here with
Emilio,
Carter,
Micah.
And today's question is, if you have a superpower, what superpower would it be?
Speak English.
Time travel.
Visibility.
Damn, you're us.
Jad.
Connor.
Maisie.
And today's question is, if you could have a superpower, what would it be?
Infinite money.
To be rich.
Flying.
Damn, you're us.
Rider.
And today's question is, if you had a superpower, what superpower would it be?
Probably teleportation. Go anywhere.
X-ray vision. If you could have any superpower, what would it be?
Infinite. Till next time of Hounds TV episode 5.
Thanks, Ben and Sam. Good morning, Hounds. This week I have a little bit different of an episode, as I was recently at Nationals for Fencing in Saskatoon. I'm going to take you over to myself at Nationals.
Good morning, Hounds. I'm here at Canadian National Fencing Championships in Saskatoon. As you can see behind me, there's lots of people here. There's about 1,500 over this passing 4 days, with 25 pieces. A little bit more on the competition.
All right, so Nationals this year for fencing was hosted in Saskatoon. This is the first time in 16 years that fencing nationals have been hosted in Saskatchewan. So that's a pretty exciting event. All right, and here's some video of me fencing Epe. If you're at all interested in learning more about the different kinds of fencing, you can read about it right here. Thanks, Hounds. I will not see you next week with another episode.
Thanks, Dane, and great job, Mason.
Yeah. Now we would like to congratulate Caden McLean, who won the Pair Award this weekend.
Yeah, and we have a clip from the ceremony, so let's take a look.
I didn't have anything prepared, obviously, but I just came up here, and one thing I want to do is just say thank you. I want to say thank you to my parents, my mom, Jackie, my dad, Colin, my two older brothers, Braden and Lana McLean. Without them, I wouldn't be half the person I am today, and that's the honest truth. And I'd like to thank my mom and my grandma for coming today. It means the whole world. My dad and my two older brothers couldn't be here. Braden's teaching, Lana's working on the farm, and dad's also putting the crop in. So, but then I also want to thank Daryl and Lori Schmidt. My parents away from home, they're another representative of why I am who I am today, and I couldn't thank them enough. And then I'd like to thank some coaches, James McGuigan, Kevin White, Del Pedrick, who's not here anymore, but was also a huge part of my development on the hockey side and as a young man. And everybody else who took part and helping me become who I am today. It's greatly appreciated, and I can't thank you guys enough. It means the world to me. And then one last thank you, last but not least, all the boys here. You guys are the ones who make the experience worthwhile, and I just want to thank you, a bunch of lifelong friends I'll have. So you guys mean the world to me, man. It's awesome. Thanks, guys.
Nice speech, Caden, and thanks for all the leadership this year.
Okay, now we have Jaden interviewing Ash from Track Day and then Sam with This Day in History.
Hello, Hounds and other viewers, and welcome back to This Day in History, which from now on will be more archive-focused. Today, we're checking out a new display in archives of Pierre Alfamari's office. This display includes the actual pictures that were in his office, like pictures of his father and of an abstract painting of sorts. His suitcase is present, as well as his real desk, chair, and coat. On the left side of the display is multiple books and photos of his time in Notre Dame, as well as a binder of letters to famous world leaders like Winston Churchill and Pierre Trudeau. This display really helps you step into Pierre's time by introducing to you to what he saw and felt. And just another thing you should check out when exploring the Notre Dame archives. That's all I have for this episode of This Day in History. See you next week.
Thanks, fellas. Now we would like to take a moment to talk about the revamped volleyball and basketball programs.
Mark French, a former coach of the Nova Scotia U16 provincial team, who is also still a scout and recruiter for Mount Royal University teams, has recently taken on the role of coach/coordinator of the basketball program.
The volleyball program will also be coming with a new look, as former Team Sask and U of R player, who in her second year led all of Canada West in digs and second in digs per set, Sierra Paris Kruger will be coming to help out with the program as the volleyball coordinator.
All right, now we're going to pass it off to Gianna, who interviewed some cast members from the drama production, and then Trey and Felicia with Challenge of the Week.
So who am I here with?
Julian.
How long have you been a Hound?
This is my first year.
What was your role in the play?
I played many different roles. We had several different scenes. I played pretty much every character in the main story, as it were, plus also some narrator parts. So.
And what was it like being on stage in front of the whole school plus alumni?
Really fun, honestly, just showing them how hard we work for the play and how talented we are in performing.
Yeah. And do you think we're going to be doing drama again next year?
Definitely, yeah.
Okay, thank you. So, who am I here with?
My name is Evil Dubois.
How long have you been a Hound?
I've been a Hound for 3 years.
What was your role in the play?
My role in the play was stagehand, so I was in the back helping with props and costumes.
And what was it like getting to be backstage for the play?
It was pretty good. It was pretty fun listening to the play and making sure everything was going as planned.
Yeah. Was there anything that you think could have gone better or worse?
I feel like our timing was a bit off, but besides that, everything else went pretty smoothly. Everyone remembered their roles and all their lines for being, so, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
So, who am I here with?
Sydney.
How long have you been a Hound?
3 years.
And what was it like sort of being behind the scenes and helping to develop the play?
I thought it was really interesting. There was a lot of new actors, and I just think everyone was so committed and excited for this opportunity. So it was a really amazing opportunity.
Yeah. And what was your role in the play?
I was bongo player and prompter.
Thank you.
Hey Hounds, welcome back to another Challenge of the Week. We're bringing back the yoga poses this week, and here's the challenge. We'll rate you from a scale of 1 to 10 on how close you are to the picture. Good luck, Hounds.
Who am I here with?
Kate.
Sasha.
And on a scale of 1 to 10, how easy do you think the challenge is?
An 8.
7.
You know I wish that I had just seen this girl. I wish that I had.
Who am I here with?
Makai.
Ken Jeffrey.
And on a scale of 1 to 10, how easy do you think the challenge is?
10.
10.
Who am I here with?
Killian.
Simon.
And on a scale of 1 to 10, how easy do you think the challenge is?
Yeah, 8.
5.
Who am I here with?
Taylor.
Jenna.
And on a scale of 1 to 10, how easy do you think the challenge is?
10.
10?
Congrats to all the Hounds who completed the challenge successfully. And I'll see you next week.
Finally, a challenge that we could beat.
What do you mean? We beat every challenge. The cameras are just turned off.
Over the past few weeks, 6 Hounds represented their province at the National Aboriginal Hockey Championship in Grand Prairie.
The NAHC is an annual tournament held at various locations across Canada.
The best U18 players from an Indigenous background represented their province against each other to compete for gold.
Pictured from left to right, Mariko Bercier, Kale Livingston, Sasha Mellenfant, Brie Martel, Alexa Albert, and Sophia Banda represented their respective provinces of Manitoba, BC, and Saskatchewan.
Great job, Hounds. Now we'll pass it off to Robbie with a baseball report, and then Eddie with play of the week.
Hello, Hounds. Today I'm here with Fearson and Dylan, and they will be explaining what baseball team they're on. Dylan?
We're on Kruger High School baseball team.
Yep. Okay. How are you guys' season so far?
Good.
It's good. I think we're 8-2 going into playoffs.
Are you guys going to playoffs?
Yeah. Right. This weekend.
What position do you guys play? Left field.
Pitcher and shortstop.
Do you like playing this position?
Yes. I very much enjoy those positions.
What is your favorite part of Rob Kruger's baseball team?
Eating spits on the bench.
I have to agree with that. And what post-game meals do you guys get?
Not Dairy Queen, Fearson.
Go to a restaurant there.
I don't know. Pizza and whatever. I don't know. Fast food.
Yes.
Thank you for
recording today.
Best.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good luck for the rest of the season.
Thank you.
Run, Brody! Brody!
Who am I here with today?
Brody Steves.
Can we know what sport event you're going to?
I did the 100, 200, 400, and javelin.
Okay, and can we know where do you place on those events?
I got first in the 100 and 200, second in the 400, and fifth in javelin.
Okay, and the last question is, what's your favorite pregame snack?
A banana.
Okay. Go! Now we'll pass it off to Dustin with Discover the Duck.
I hope this is the week I finally find it.
Hey Hans, welcome back to another week of Discover the Duck. As you know, I'm Dustin, a new owner on this segment. And I want to congratulate Edward on finding last week's duck. Here's your next hint for this week. I hope you have fun and discover the duck. Good luck, Hounds.
Great job, Eddie, but Sam and I are finding it this week. Look out.
All right, Hounds, that's all from Ben and I.
This was Hounds TV episode 12. See you next week.